Hello, this is Mark from tradeinform.com and welcome to this video on how to calculate drawdown in Excel for traders. This video is part of a series that I am doing on the most important trading metrics, both to analyze your trading performance and also to help you develop new trading strategies and backtest them. Drawdown may well be the single most important trading metric, because this is the one that can make us abandon our trading strategies, both if we have a succession of too many large losses and also if our losses last for too long. So I'm going to calculate drawdown in two different ways and show you how you can do that in Excel. The first of these is drawdown expressed as a percentage from the previous highest point in our capital. And the second of these is drawdown duration. This is how long in time our drawdown has lasted from peak to peak. So we're going to calculate that in the spreadsheet that is on the screen at the moment. And this is a trade-informed backtest model. And we can do all sorts of different analysis in this model. And I'm going to click onto here, which gives us the thing that we need to start analysing drawdown, and that is capital. This is our capital over time. So as each time period passes, our capital will get higher and lower, depending on our trading strategy performance. So first of all, we calculate drawdown. The first thing we need to do is take this, our current period, and divide it by the previous maximum. And I'm going to do this as the maximum of all the previous periods. And we can do that in Excel by this formula here, equals current period divided by the previous max. And if we press F4, we make this a fixed absolute reference cell, which will not change if we drag the formula down. And I'm going to express this as a positive percentage, so I'm going to put it as 1 minus this figure and copy that down. Okay, so we've got our drawdown here. The next thing we need to have is our peaks. So I'm going to do a very simple if formula. We use if formulas for any sort of logical test in any sort of programming, and particularly in Excel. So if current capital is greater than previous value, then we're going to take that. So that's going to be our peak up until that point. Otherwise, we will take our previous value. So a nice easy if statement there. Copy it down. There we have a column that is just showing our peak value at any point in time. And then I'm going to use this third column here, which is going to calculate the time in between each peak. Again, I'm going to start off with a nice if logical statement, and I'm going to say that if our current capital equals the peak, in other words, if we are currently at a peak, then there is no time at all because we are at a peak. But in every other situation, I'm going to add 1. So there are two very easy if statements, and copy them down. Now I've got the value here in a row, and what I'm going to do is we always want to automate our Excel spreadsheet so we don't have to mess around changing ranges. So what I've done already is put these into a range, and if you don't currently use ranges, named ranges in Excel, then I recommend you do that. They're very easy to use. I've got one here, I've already named it as drawdown, and the way I do it and the way that you can do it is using the offset function here. And we basically offset from this first point by the amount of values in the row. So this will create a range which will expand when we add new data. So now I can go back here and we've got two cells here that need populating, and very easily we know that we're looking at the maximum drawdown, so we use the equals max built-in Excel function, and I can just use this named range that I was just describing there. It's called drawdown, and it will automatically pull through the maximum drawdown that we've calculated. Now if we want to get the maximum drawdown duration, well, I've done another range for that, and we use again the Excel formula equals max. And if I just start typing this in, we can put it in here, equals drawdown duration. And then we see we have a time period of 690 trading days where we failed to go make any advance on our peak to peak. And if we look here at the chart, it's not too difficult to see where that may have occurred. We're looking here at 2007 and we just peak above there in 2010. We can express this in years if we like, approximately 250 trading days per year. And so we can see that we're looking at 2 years, something like 2 years, 9 months. So we have a long period where this strategy has not made any profit. So that's interesting information. However, we can see also that we have a flat line, and the flat line here is telling us we didn't take any trades at all during this period. This was the financial crisis, 2008-2009, and so this strategy using a filter of long only trades didn't trade at all. But we still have this information, and it is a useful metric for us to know and to understand. I hope you found this video useful on how to calculate drawdown for traders. If you would like more videos like this, please remember to subscribe. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. And for more information about backtesting in Excel and about the financial markets, please go to www.tradeinformed.com.